Shreya here, and if you can see, I'm in a slightly different setting today, and that's because I'm at my friend's house because the both of us are going to film a very informative video for you guys.
Hi guys, my name is Viraj and I am the aforementioned friend.
So he is one of those people who actually helps me with a lot of the rescues. Actually, I've learned a lot from him. And today we are going to discuss feeding of stray dogs and cats in the locality that we live in. What I want to start off by saying is that we have been taught, and even in the constitution it says so, that it is our fundamental duty to take care of the surroundings, to take care of our surroundings. And We have been taught through our value education books that, you know, dog is man's best friend and this and that, and you should feed them and you should take care of them. But we are a bit, if not a lot, hypocritical about this, because when it comes to doing it actively, it becomes a problem and issue for a lot of people around us who do not agree with having them around. So Let me establish that this video is going to aim to create harmony amongst our surroundings and us. We are very lucky to be living in a place where we can interact with, I can't say wildlife, but we can interact with other species so much, be it flora or fauna, and we really take it for granted. Question.
Yeah.
Why do we want to feed stray dogs?
Well, apart from the obvious that just like us, they are living creatures, they get hungry, they want food, they might not necessarily get as much as they need.
Right.
There's a lot of benefits for human society as a whole when we actually end up feeding dogs.
Correct. And what could they be?
Well, for one, a healthier ecosystem. As you know, in a society which does not have cats, there's a lot of rat infestations, there's a lot of insects,
correct,
many things like that. Second of all, you won't have stray animals rummaging and littering, dropping trash cans,
because when they're hungry,
all over the road.
They will scavenge. They will scavenge for food when they're hungry.
Right. Yes.
There are fewer dogs running behind people carrying polythenes or, you know, food stuff in their hand. Because again, like I said, they will look for food if they're hungry. Any animal has a natural instinct of looking for food when it's hungry. So if you have dogs that are well fed, they will be less aggressive and running after humans for food, or they will generally trust humans more because it is us who are feeding them.
But they are used to humans around them, in their presence. They will not treat humans differently. They will not treat them as if we are foreign or we are someone who does not belong in their space.
In retrospect, let's just internalize the fact that we are the ones who have kind of invaded their area. So we need to seem less of a predator or less of another species or a competitive species to them that causes harm. We have to be in tandem with them. We have to work with them because they are a part of our environment and they do contribute a lot to our environment.
For thousands of years humans have coexisted, especially with cats and dogs.
Right.
We've lived and evolved alongside them.
Right.
So to say, hey, they do not belong here is actually contradictory to most of human history.
Right. And not just human history, but it's contradictory, like I said, and very hypocritical to our own teachings and values. The real case here is that this utopia that we imagine that we exist in, we really don't. There are a lot of problematic individuals that will interrupt with dog feeding or cat feeding or stray feeding, basically. And there are cases where they will go as far as to hurt people, injure them or harass them just so that these dogs don't get fed, which I don't see what good that will do to anyone else. So if there is anyone who thinks that not feeding dogs will cause them to go away or will reduce the population in that area, I'm sorry, but you're very wrong. You're just going to get hungry, angry dogs. That's what you're going to get.
Factually speaking, dogs are going to go wherever they can find food. Now,
right.
if you are living in a residential area, there is going to be food. Now, the choice is yours. Either the food can be
from the trash,
which is, apart from the fact that it's not really the healthiest for the dogs, it's just going to make a mess of your own locality and promote rats. and other vermin.
And disease.
And disease, not to mention, especially in times like these, 2020 reference.
Yeah.
You would want dogs to end up, you know, knowing that food is going to be available to them.
At a certain time. From certain places.
From certain people.
So that they kind of, again, like I said, do not cause trouble.
Yeah.
Which they won't if they find food. Okay. And dogs, especially unlike cats, are stray dogs have more or less now become scavengers. They don't technically hunt anymore. So it's not like cats that they will catch pigeons or catch mice and eat them. So they have to be fed. There is no other way.
How to protect the legal rights of us feeders from those who are armed with WhatsApp forwards?
And WhatsApp forwards, WhatsApp University is one of the worst universities you could learn from. And a lot of these forwards come from unreliable, untrustworthy sources.
WhatsApp forward, for example.
This was one that we received on 8th October this year and on our feeders group. So it says, feeding of any animals on street and public places is against law and it will affect health of animals as they are not prepared for cooked food with salt and sugar. We'll come to the cooked food with salt and sugar part later. But let me debunk these while I'm at it. As per Mumbai Municipal Act 1888 and Indian Forest Act, feeding of stray or wild animals is illegal. And I'm not saying it because
they can't spell.
Okay, let me debunk all of these. I did my research. I went to the Mumbai Municipal Act 1888. I looked on the page anything regarding to stray dogs or cats. And the only thing that I got was about taxes and if the dogs are a nuisance. And we'll discuss that later also.
And according to the Indian Forest Act, guess what?
There is no mention of the words stray or dog feed.
It has nothing to do with this.
Okay. Cleaning of public areas is big problem as most of people left food and don't take care for cleaning. I don't even know what that means.
You know, this brings me to the main mix-up which I feel many people think. You know how some people, when they have an extra roti lying at home and they don't want to eat it, they just throw it on the road.
That's not dog
thinking
feeding.
Thinking that, koi kha lega kutta.
That is not feeding. That is not feeding in general.
Yeah.
That is throwing trash.
That is littering.
Okay.
Big difference.
Love animals is as important as cleaning area. Dog pup cleaning. As people walking and children are playing, this will also affect hygiene condition.
What does that even mean?
I don't see why they type things in English anymore. Feeding dog or any animal, inviting them in group, and because of that many animals coming from surrounding also, and conflicts between animals creating problem for children and two-wheelers. I am assuming they're
so
talking about dogs barking and fighting.
Saw...
And we already mentioned that dogs will fight, get aggressive and bark at each other only when they're hungry. Or mostly when they're hungry.
You know, it would take a dog to be really, really very hungry for it to even, you know, think of your children as food.
Yeah.
Honestly, if dogs in your area are getting to that level of hunger, maybe there's something wrong with your locality.
Yeah. We should know that we are on edge of forest, which is highest density of leopard in world, and dog is main food for them. And if any accident happened due to this, we have to avoid. Also, trash attracts pigs and pigs attracts leopards.
Yeah.
And trash is spilled by dogs.
And
if
trash,
they are not fed.
And trash attracts mice, and these mice get into our buildings and our sewer lines and our homes.
And the trash is spilled if the dogs aren't fed.
Right.
So you see the links forming here. Fastest and fittest law of nature. Artificial feeding will make animals dependent. It will not harmful to animals, but also for their coming generations. Many studies says that.
Wow, quote even
love
one of
them,
these many studies.
But at the same time, your love against nature will harmful.
WhatsApp University ki jai ho.
By quoting some actual laws and sections of the constitutions or the Indian Penal Code. Restricting, prohibiting or causing inconvenience to any person feeding a street dog or animal is a punishable offense. mischief by killing or maiming animals. Whoever commits mischief by killing, poisoning, maiming or rendering useless any animal shall be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 2 years or with fine or both. So what this means is, this is from the PC Act, which is Prevention of Cruelty to Animals, 1960. And what this means is, any person maiming, poisoning or hurting an animal is punishable for 2 years by law.
Next section we are going to cover is section 51AG. To protect and to improve the natural environment, including forests, lakes, rivers and wildlife, and to have, I quote, compassion for living creatures.
And this is a fundamental duty under the Constitution. Whomsoever threatens another with any injury to his person, reputation or property, or to the person or reputation of anyone in whom that person is interested, with intent to cause harm to that person, or to cause that person to do any act which he is not legally bound to do, or to omit any act which that person is legally entitled to do, as the means of avoiding the execution of such threat, commits criminal intimidation.
So basically put, what she is trying to say is, if there's any person who's trying to stop us from feeding animals, or stopping anyone from feeding a stray animal or caring for a stray animal, which that action itself is legal, by either threatening someone or forcing them not to do it through any form of threats or coercion or harm, is the person actually doing the illegal thing. So if someone comes up to you, a feeder, and says, hey, you're not supposed to feed dogs and I'm going to stop you from feeding dogs, that person is the one who's doing something illegal, not the feeder. Because feeding is, under the Constitution of India, a legal act.
So that is why, and what they are basically doing is a criminal intimidation of
simply the Indian court. Simply put, feeders, caretakers for stray animals and all animals alike, you are on the good side of the law. What you are doing is completely legal, completely good for society. Those who stop you, who inconvenience you, and who want to put an end to your caretaking and feeding, are the ones who are actually doing something wrong, doing something illegal.
Doing something criminal, actually. So I think we can end the video here.
Yeah, that was good.
And that was a good one.
All links to the articles mentioned
Actual articles of the Constitution and the news articles.
All link in the description. So guys, stay in touch. Keep watching for more future content, which is really going to be good. Okay, covering certain topics which are quite similar to this, among a lot of other things. Subscribe to her channel. Great content here.
Thanks, Viraj. That was a really good video, and I look forward to making more videos with you.
There shall be.
Yeah. And since we both are so commonly interested on this topic, we will be following up with other videos related to animals, like animal behavior, what to feed and what not to feed, since we have told you to feed the animals, and even other things like the ecosystems and animal rescues and whatnot. So, all the best to us for all of those, and keep watching. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.